Alright, hi guys. So today we'll look at Valuable 1 and TJL. A lot of people wanted me to do Valuable 1, so I decided to do it in this video, and also I decided to include TJL in it because I think that it has a really strong monthly chart. So we'll get into that on the second part of this video. So to start things off, let's quickly move into Valuable 1. So the normal procedure that we do all the time, we zoom out of the chart and we look at the overall trend. So as of now, the overall trend is positive. You can see that prices are in a clear uptrend since it bottomed out in during the COVID-19 lows, and since then prices have gone up a lot. Now if you look at if you zoom in a bit, you can see that after we had this major dump during January, we can see the prices have been consolidating below the January highs. So once we move further into the analysis and when we look at the chart patterns, you will see that price action is predicting a possible new all-time high Valuable 1. We'll get into it later on, but as of now, what you need to know is that prices are, despite being in an overall uptrend, prices are consolidating as of now. So let's now quickly move into the moving averages. So normally we look at the 20, 50 and the 200 day moving average. So as of now, you can see that the 200 day moving average is sloping up, and the slope is positive. And also at the same time, we can see that the 20 is above the 50, meaning that the overall trend, the short term, the medium term and the long term trend is positive. Now, if you look a bit more closely into this, you can see that the prices have gone below the 20-day moving average. So if you have watched my previous videos, I've always said that I'm not mostly interested in whether prices break below a moving average. I'm mostly interested in the slope of the moving average. So just because prices are below a moving average, for me, is not bearish unless the slope starts to flatten out and also start trending down along with prices. So unless that doesn't happen, most likely what we might see is prices quickly reverse and close back above the moving average. So as of now, the short term, the medium term and the long term trend is positive for Valuable 1. So now we have looked at the trend through moving averages. So let's quickly jump into some chart patterns. So one of the things that I've highlighted since almost months ago is this symmetrical triangle over here. So you can clearly see that there is a large symmetrical triangle on this chart. Now if you look at this, you can clearly see that we had a very strong breakout during these 2 days. Now if you looked at my previous videos, how we look how we confirm a breakout is one, through a close above resistance, a proper close. We also said that we might include a percentage filter. For example, if prices need to close at least 3% above a certain level to warrant a valid breakout. And at the same time, we also said that volume needs to come in, and volume needs to be pretty heavy on the side of the breakout. So you can clearly see that we have had very strong buying pressure on those two candles. So we have a confirmed breakout over here. And since then, what we can see is that prices are pulling back towards support. So a support level over here is probably the most important level for Valuable 1 to hold. It's around this 70 level. So 70 rupees is a very key level for Valuable 1 to hold. If prices do close below that level, that's a bit of a sign of weakness. Not necessarily a sign to sell your counter, but it does indicate a sign of weakness. So a key level to watch for is this 70 rupee level. So that can be, if you're a short-term trader, that can be a possible stop level. So how we stop ourselves out, if you watch my previous videos, how I explain it is, if you are looking at the daily time frame, we need to see a daily close below a certain level to confirm that we need to stop ourselves out and stay on the sidelines until price action starts favoring our method of analyzing charts. So as of now, price action looks strong. We are seeing a pullback, which is good, and most importantly, the pullback is coming on very low volumes. So you can see the selling pressure relative to buying over the past few weeks have been very strong. Buying pressure relative to selling pressure has been very strong over the past few weeks. So that's something good to see. Another way how we define an uptrend is when we see increasing volume as prices move up and decreasing volume as prices consolidate or pull back. So you can see the prices moved up and along with it we can see the volume also trended higher. And at the same time, as prices threw back to support, we can see that volume has also reduced along with it. So that is a good sign. Now, would I look to get in at these levels? I don't see why not. It's a good level to enter at if you're a short-term trader. So again, that being said, this is where I would enter. That does not mean that you have to enter the same level. So you need to obviously adjust your risk level according to the way you invest and according to your own strategy. So for me, if I was to get in on this stock, I think 70 rupees is a good level to get in, and my risk level would be just below 70. So if prices close below this 69 area, that's when I would stop myself out, and my risk would roughly be around 3-4%, which is a good risk level as well. So for me, as of now, Valuable One is at a good level, possibly where buyers would start coming in now. So right, so let's quickly look at a price target. So price targets, again, the same way we measure flags and all of that, we measure the height of the pattern. So the height of the pattern over here is roughly at around it's at around 84 rupees, and the low point over here is at around 40. Let's take it as 40. Let's take it as 41. So that gives us roughly around 43 points to the upside. So assuming that the breakout happened at around this 70 rupee level, our price target is roughly at around 113 rupees. So it's roughly around over here. So just to go through how we did it again, we take the height of the pattern, we get around 43 points if I'm not mistaken, and then we add it to the breakout level. Again, we are assuming, because we can't get an exact level at which point the price broke out, but it looks roughly at around 70 rupees. So you add 43 points to 70 rupees and you get a target of 113 rupees. So that is predicting a new all-time high for Valuable One. So now that we have figured out a price target, obviously our stop level, like I've explained, is below around this 70 to 69 level. So if price is close below that level, that's where I would look to stop myself out. So I think I have pretty much gone through all the important things on the chart. So let's quickly summarize what we spoke about. So we know that the overall trend is positive on Valuable One. We can see that the 20, 50 and the 200 day moving averages are well aligned. We can also see the prices had a very strong breakout on volume, which validates the breakout. And after that, we have seen a throwback towards this key support level, which is roughly at around 69 to 70. So which is most likely where buyers might come in. No guarantees on that. So if you're looking to get in, my stop level would probably be on a close below the 70 to 69 level. If you want, you can have your stop on a close below this 50 moving average, which is currently at around 68.40 cents. So it can be either of those levels. Worst case would be probably below 68.40. So if you want to give more flexibility, you can have your stop below that level. So and we figured out a price target of 113 rupees as well. So in terms of risk to reward, it is very good, because you're just looking at roughly at around two points or 3 points to the downside and around 42 points to the upside. So that's a very strong risk to reward ratio as well. So that's about it on Valuable One. If you have any questions, you can comment below and I will be happy to answer your questions. So that's on Valuable One. Let's quickly move into TJL. Right, so TJL, let's just look at the daily chart before we look into the month chart, which is where the pattern is. So like we have seen an overall uptrend on TJL since this COVID-19 lows over here, and we can clearly see the prices are trending higher. So now let's quickly look at the moving averages. We can see that the moving averages are also showing a period of consolidation, and rightly so. You can clearly see that TJL is consolidating within this range. And if you have watched my previous videos, I have told you that moving averages are trending indicators. So in a period of consolidation, they aren't of any help to us, because the moving averages only signal give at least a decent signal only when prices are trending. If prices aren't trending, moving averages aren't going to help, and we need to focus on proper support and resistance levels. So as of now, once we move into the monthly chart, we'll look at the exact resistance level. But as of now, resistance roughly lies around this 47 to 47.5 ish area. So that is where our main resistance level is at. So now we have figured out that currently the short term and the medium term trend is under consolidation. So we do not have a proper trend, as of now the trend is neutral, but the overall primary trend is positive and favoring the buyers. So let's quickly look at a chart pattern that we saw here, if you guys probably would have seen it. But this looks roughly like an ascending triangle. So over here, so right around this level. So this is pretty good ascending triangle. So how we measure price target from this is by taking the height of the pattern. We know that roughly we can take the height of the pattern at around 46 rupees, and the lowest point is around 18 rupees, I think. Yeah, so we have 46 and we minus 18 from 46, and we get the height of the pattern as 28 points. And then what we do is we add it to the breakout level. We assume that the breakout level is roughly at around 46. So we add that, we add the height of the pattern to the breakout level, which we have assumed, which is at 46, and it gives us a price target of roughly around 74 rupees. Roughly over here. So the according to this pattern, this what you call an ascending triangle, the price target is at 74 rupees. So where can a stop loss be? So if you want to have a worst case stop level, it will go below this trend line over here. So we have a clear trend line, which is an important trend line, which connects the COVID-19 lows to this low over here. So you can have your stop level below this trend line. So I mean, as prices move higher, the trend line will obviously increase. That means that your stop level will also increase. So as of now, looking at it, your stop level would be roughly below around 40 rupees. So roughly around, it's just a tad below around a 9% risk level. So in terms of risk level, it's not that bad because we have much more stronger upside. So in terms of a risk to reward basis, it's a pretty good trade. So if you want to have a worst case stop level, that would be below around 40 rupees as of now. So if prices close below 40 on the daily chart, then that most likely means that you need to stop yourself out and stay out of it until there's proper direction that favors the buyers. So that's on the daily chart. So let's quickly jump into the monthly chart to look at the pattern that I'm talking about. So we saw an ascending triangle on the daily chart. So what we see here as of now is also what we call a right angle broadening wedge. Now, had you watched my previous video yesterday, you'd have seen this pattern. I'll post the link below. You can go and watch the video as well. So what we see here is a right angle broadening wedge, a bullish right angle broadening wedge. Why we call it broadening is because unlike an ascending triangle where you have a horizontal line over here and then you have another upward sloping line which is moving towards the horizontal line, here you can see that the two lines are converging away from each other. So that is why we call it broadens away from each other. So that's why we call it a broadening pattern. So how we measure a price target from here is, again, we do the same thing. We measure the height of the pattern. So roughly we can assume that the height is around 47.50 rupees, and the lowest point of the chart is roughly at around 18 rupees. So we take the height, which is roughly around 29.5 points, and we add it to the breakout level, which you're assuming is at around 47.50 ish, and we get a price target of 77 rupees. So both patterns on the daily and the monthly corresponds to pretty much a very similar level. Daily chart price target was, I think, around 74 rupees, and our monthly price target is roughly at around 77 rupees. So you're looking at a move towards this range over here. So so that was what I wanted to highlight, because this looks a much more cleaner chart unlike the one that we saw on the daily. So in terms of a stop level, what you can do is your worst case stop can go below this level as well. So right over here, so that's around 3750. So this is a possible stop level for you to have. So if prices close below 3750 on the monthly chart, that's when I would stop myself out. Now you can see the reason why prices are stalling around these areas is because clearly you can see the prices are near the all-time highs that it reached way back in 2016. So clearly you can expect some heavy supply around this range, and apparently I think there's a lot of foreign selling going on as well. So once all of that is absorbed, I do strongly believe that we can see a very strong breakout in TJL, and we can see a very impulse move like what we saw in Richard Pearse. The symbol is RICH. So I'm expecting a similar move like what we saw in Rich in TJL as well. Once the selling is done and once everything gets absorbed, I believe we can have a very strong breakout and a strong run very soon. So that's what I'm expecting. Again, obviously manage your risk. There's no guarantee that it will happen the way I'm saying it will. So again, we have so let's briefly go through everything that we've spoken about. We know that the overall primary trend is positive, but the medium and short term trend is signaling a consolidation phase. We figure out two patterns. One is ascending triangle, which is on the daily chart, and the right angle broadening wedge, which is a bullish pattern, which is on the monthly chart. We have figured out two price targets, one at 74 and one at 77. So that's roughly a price or a range where you can target. And also, most importantly, we know that we do not have confirmation on either of the patterns. So none of the patterns have been broken out. Prices haven't broken out above either of the patterns. So up till now, we do not have proper confirmation. So once we get confirmation, we might most likely see a strong move to the upside. And in terms of risk, we have identified two levels. One is on a close below that trend line that I spoke about on the daily chart, which was roughly as of now around 40 rupees. If you want a much more flexible risk level, then it would be on a monthly close below 3750 rupees. So I think both TJL and Valuable One has very strong potential, and something that definitely should be on your watch list. If you get a trade, if you get into the stock or not, that's completely up to you. That depends on whether you like the stock or whether you feel comfortable buying it. So that's perfectly up to you, but this is definitely something that I would have on my watch list and look to get into a trade, provided that it corresponds with my risk levels and my price targets and what I'm expecting to make over the short term. So depends on your strategy. Like I said, it doesn't always have to be the way I trade. Make your own strategy and make sure that strategy is something that you're comfortable with. So that's about it on TJL as well. If you have any questions, always don't worry to ask them in the comment section. I'll be happy to reply. So that's about it. Make sure to like, subscribe the video. Most importantly, like the video, because it helps the YouTube algorithm and helps me grow my channel. So thank you for watching the video, guys. I hope you guys have a happy new year, and hope to post the video very soon. Thank you, guys. Thank you for watching.